Hello everyone, welcome to another exciting section of Obichem Consult Limited presentation. We are going to be looking at making safety habits. Before I go into the presentation proper, I want to leave you with these two words or two statements or two sentences, whatever you call it is. Break bad habits, develop good habits. Break bad habits, develop good habits. We're going to the presentation, which is Making Safety Habits, a presentation of Obichem Consult Limited. We look at this presentation under the following thematic areas. We look at definitions, we look at listing up and learn up for safety, we look at look up for safety, then leave out safety. Go to the first thematic, which is definitions. We look at habits. What are habits? Habits are acquired behavior pattern regularly followed until they have become almost involuntary. A lifestyle that you have lived over time. A pattern that you have followed over time. And that pattern becomes part of you. And has become almost involuntary. That's what habits is all about. Then safety habits are habits that protect us from danger, risk, or injury. Those things we do that extricates us from danger, from harm, or injury, they are safety habits. But I want to let you know you can make safety habits. Takes 21 days to form a habit. You just start it, before you know it become part of you and you always walk safe. Go to the next thematic, which is listing up and learn up for safety. What do we mean by listing up or learning up for safety? Mean you make it a habit to gather all the information you need to stay safe. Everything you need to do to stay safe, to extricate yourself from harm, from danger or injury, you gather those ideas, you gather those knowledge. You listen to safety trainings and presentation. You cover time when you listen to trainings on safety. You listen to presentations on safety. That is how you listen up and you learn up for safety. By studying, you acquire new safety ideas and information. You soak up new safety information. Every new information about safety that you have gotten, you soak it and make sure it is part and parcel of you. Ask questions you don't understand or safety meetings. Then talk to co-workers, talk to family members, talk to friends on safety matters. We'll go to the next thematic, which is look up for safety. Look up for safety information. You get into an area, get into a new work site. You look up, are there safety informations that I need to read that are pasted on the walls or on the notice board? You look up for them, for safety signs. You get into a new work area or a new place. Are there safety signs that are inscribed somewhere that I need to know and I need to look up for? You gaze at them. You focus at them, you stare at them, you look up for those signs, you look up for safety symbols. Are they safety symbols? Take for instance, you are driving and you want to drive into a particular factory or a particular company and you see a safety symbol there. No seat belts, no entry. Look up for those safety symbols. You want to walk in an area that is slippery. You look out for those safety symbols and writings or instructions. Wet floor, slippery areas. Check out for hazards in your home, offices, and school. In checking up for hazards, what hazard did you check up for? Physical hazards. Factors that can cause harm when you come in contact with them. You look up for chemical hazards. Hazards associated with the use of chemical. You are into chemical handling. You look up for safety hazards, chemical hazard. This chemical, do they cause blurred vision? This chemical, do they irritate the skin? This chemical, if inhaled, if ingested, can they affect my respiratory system? You look up for chemical hazards. Look up for biological hazards, substances that can pose threats to the health of humans. Then you look up for ergonomic hazards. Hazards in your environment that can cause harm to your musculoskeletal system. Let's go to the next thematic, which is leave out safety. How do you leave out safety? As you live your life, you leave out safety on a daily basis. You leave out safety on a weekly basis. You leave out safety on a monthly basis. You leave out safety all through the year. Leave it out. Put on the required personal protective equipment for every job, every task, the task that you have. There's a required PPE for that. Take for instance, you want to go into a noisy area to work. You need an earmuff. That is it. You want to go into a confined space to work. You need a respirator. So you need the required personal protective equipment for the job that you have at hand. You must always use the right tool for every task. Take for instance, you want to screw something into, let's say you want to screw a nail. You don't go and use a tester. You use a screwdriver because that is the right tool for that task. If a job or task is unsafe, don't do it. You must cultivate the habit of saying no to unsafe job and unsafe task. Work with a job hazard analysis document where necessary. What's the job hazard analysis document? Sometimes in some organizations they call it job safety analysis, JSA. It's a document that lists the task you want to do in a sequential order and the associated hazard or the hazard associated with that task for every step or sequence that you want to follow and the requisite precautions to take so as to avert those hazards. So there are tasks that you need to work with a job hazard analysis document or a job safety analysis document. Then lastly, like safety, like it. Safety is cheap, accident is costly. So like safety, love safety, and leave out safety. Thank you for listening. If you have questions and you have comments, I'm going to display some of our handles on the screen. You could send in your questions and you could drop your comments in these handles. This presentation is coming to you courtesy of OVCHEM Consult Limited. OVCHEM Consult Limited is engineering firm, environmental services, safety training, and chemicals. Our mobile numbers are rightly displayed on the presentation, as you can see on the screen. Our email address is there. You can send us a mail. You need to ask some questions, make some clarification. If you have a need of any of these services that we offer, you send us a mail, put a call across to us. You could also follow us on Facebook at www.facebook.com/OVCHEM. You can like our Facebook page as well. You could follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and you could subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, thank you for listening and have a wonderful time. Bye for now.